This is a digital presentation for the PNS Digital Journey on Monday, 21st of September. I will present a joint work with Bruna De Marchi and other colleagues based on the experience of a European Union Horizon 2020 Cities Health Project running on the years 2019 and 2021. The Cities Health Project is a citizen science for urban environment and health, involves partners from five European countries, and consists of five pilot studies. Barcelona in Spain and Lucca in Italy on air pollution and health, Amsterdam on wood burning and health, Ljubljana in Slovenia on urban noise and health, and Kaunas in Lithuania on city design and health. All the five pilot studies represent several kinds of citizen science initiatives in the field of environmental epidemiology. For example, pilots led by institutions and pilots in which citizen groups engaged researchers. My talk will address four points, illustrated by the Italian pilot study within the Cities Health Project. The complexity of every citizen science initiative is the first point. It's well known that citizen science embraces a heterogeneous set of study design, activities, projects, and so on. This heterogeneity is present also within a single citizen science initiative, together with some heterogeneity of ends. Second point is the transdisciplinary characteristics of citizen science initiatives framed in a PNS analysis. The extended peer community forces a continuous mutual redefinition of roles and expertise. The third point is the participatory approach in environmental epidemiology. Due to the longer tradition of citizen science in environmental fields, setting up participatory study design is a hot topic, particularly when claimed pollution episodes are to be considered. The last point, which cannot be ignored, is the changing landscape of the epidemiologic initiative due to the COVID-19 pandemics. Our Italian pilot includes some traditional citizen science activities, like those aimed to measure air pollutant concentrations. The pilot came from pre-existing citizen science projects, Che Aria Tira, sponsored by a citizen committee, Mamme No Inceneritore, covering several Italian regions, as shown in the picture to the left. Do It Yourself particle sensors, owned by single citizen, are connected in a national network. The local committee and private citizens in the area covered by the pilot developed their own monitoring network and joined the large national citizen science network. At the same time, they are part of a Cities Health pilot. Within the pilot, scientists focused on heavy metal pollution from a copper foundry active since 1916. Citizens were engaged in planning the future of their community. In the picture, A recent public manifestation in support of a participatory process, as regulated by a Tuscany regional law, about the deliberation of a new energy plant to be built by the copper foundry. Scientists were interested in the history of the industrialization of the areas. Citizens were calling for social accountability and responsibility of the industry. The 1916-born industry was a classic example of philanthropic capitalism. The village of Fornaci was founded as residence of the workers. Houses, the church, schools were built by the industry. The industry employed a large female workforce, leading to a growing autonomy and emancipation of women in a previously poor and rural territory. The extended peer community was active since the beginning of the pilot, mainly due to long-standing interaction between one of us and the citizens of the area. The epidemiology design was continuously discussed, and the study objective, methods, data gathering, and study conduct were co-defined with scientists. The primary objective was to measure prevalence of chronic kidney disease. This aim evolves in the idea of storing blood sample for future use, eventually measuring other biological and politically relevant endpoints. How to maintain property of biologic materials stored in a biobank is an open question. One option we discussed is to set up something similar to a biotrust in the definition of Vinnikov and Vinnikov. We call that biolibrary. The citizen science initiative evolves in previously unintended way, and participated data management and governance is currently under discussion. The extended peer community is the place where trust is continuously regenerated. It is not guaranteed, but needs to be sustained and threats need to be identified. In this process, we set up a series of public events aimed to anticipate all potential outcomes of the epidemiological investigation. What will I be? The answer may not be as comforting as in Doris Day's Hunger in Hitchcock's movie. Answering uncomfortably, like epidemiologic result will be inconclusive, or catastrophically, like there will be a large disease burden, should be considered. Prospecting scenarios addresses the uncertainty in every epidemiologic investigation. The debate is, however, not limited to citizens and scientists. Local institutions, city mayors, are required to express their intentions at the face of each distinct scenario, a crucial step in which any hidden agenda may be uncovered. There is no time to deepen this point, but we may have opportunity to spend some more words in the discussion. The pandemic, of course, cannot be ignored. Difficulties due to the lockdown measures can be easily imagined. Public events, meetings, even minor activities were cancelled out. What I like to underline here is that the participatory process on the deliberation about the plant continued, notwithstanding the lockdown procedures, mainly because public meetings already took place, and therefore the motivation to participate to the epidemiologic study was maintained. There was a continuous exchange with the local physicians, also members of extended peer community. One nice slide, side product, was the analysis of air pollution in the period pre-lockdown, during the lockdown, and after the lockdown. Citizen science sensors provided microdata with some interesting and unexpected results compared to the more trivial macro analysis we can find in the media. As shown in the slide, the pollution data in the period of March-May 2020, during the lockdown, were similar to those monitored in the same period of the last year. But after end of lockdown, in the period of June-August 2020, they shows a marked reduction of pollutant concentration compared to the previous year. More specifically, there was no reduction, according to the monitoring station close to the copper foundry in the lockdown period, but only after, pending the economic crisis. Thanks for the attention.